Did you work on it? Or we do it together? I'm just working myself. See this achieve on the screen?
Yes.
You are? Okay, let's get back to the program. But this is the last component, the analyst part. So, example, play is a statement of profit or loss for the year ended the 1st December 2025. We have revenue, cost of sales, of expenses, finance, well, and the rest. Then we have the additional information. We are told that Gary acquired the deposit of me on January 2025. Goodwill on acquisition has been impaired by 1 million during the year and should be charged to operating expenses for goodwill method. During the year, NIT sold 10 million goods to Gary at a markup of 25% on cost. 1/4 of those goods are in at the year. So obviously here we need to do a bit of some computations on the realized profit. So the first thing that we have to do, we need to just remove this. So we need to show the revenue, cost of sales. Yeah, we need to make some adjustment on the analyzed profit, so we need to calculate the analyzed profit. Then we'll go to gross profit. Start with the parent, check on the subsidiary, make an adjustment, whatever that will be made. Then we'll have now the group. Revenue, we get back to the question. On revenue, we had 120,000 and 90,000. Maybe them just add this. We have 120,000.
90,000.
4 months. Just arrange this thing nicely. We have 90,000. Then on cost of sales, is it 70,000?
Yes, 70,000.
And the other side on the subsidiary is how much?
40,000.
The nice profit will make the thing later on, but you can still say some figures from here. Expenses.
Thank you.
This is how much we have?
We have 20,000
and 5,000. house we have. And down we have if there'll be obvious an issue of doing some impairments, isn't it? We'll do the calculations of the impairments. Then below the impairments, whatever we have, we have the finance cost. Finance cost under the parent undertaking is how much?
5,000.
5,500. Just 500. Oh, these are minus, eh? Okay.
Yeah,
let me do this. So down here, then we have, is it a profit or what? Profit before tax.
Finance cost. Finance cost is 2,000 under parent.
2,500.
Not 20. 2,000. And 500.
Then we have what for your tax, profit before tax.
Yes.
So we have to do like that. Profit before tax, what other things do we have? Of taxation, right?
Of tax.
So how much is for the parent company?
6,000.
$6,000. Then for the subsidiary?
$3,000.
Oh, then again, yes.
That's the expense.
But expenses, so it's just the major. Which is basically the profit for the year. So, looking at the question, we first need to calculate the annualized profit, provision for annualized profit, the PAP. And just do some computation. Let me see, just within a minute, tell me what you have calculated on the annualized profit. I'm waiting. Actually, how much are you getting?
The markup. On the markup, I'm getting.
The annualized profit. The annualized profit.
Annualized profit is 625.
Annualized profit. Percentage. Getting 625. Angela, how much are you getting? We'll do it together, but can you give me some? 625.
Let's
we need to understand, do you know the difference between markup and margin? Margin, now write it somewhere. Margin is based on revenue. Markup is based on cost. Then we'll do the computation, and this is why I'm doing this, because I wanted to see how it fits.
Markup is based on?
On cost. So for example, if we are looking at markup, meaning that the cost will be at 100. The cost will be at 100, then sales will be the cost plus whatever markup you have, which is 125%, then the revenue will be at 125. Cost will be at 100. If you are looking at the okay, then meaning that revenue is going to be at 100% and cost will be 100% less whatever you have there. So always sticking together, let me just explain.
You're breaking up, yeah.
When you hear margin, on the margin,
yes,
meaning that revenue is at 100%. So they are computing whatever margin you are computing, 100%.
Okay. You're breaking up.
Sorry. Okay, let me again. I hope that
you're breaking up now. Tell us even today.
Yeah, and this is much better, isn't it?
At least
it's so better it than markup. Yeah. Yeah. If it's markup, I don't know what is happening to copper because it's different. Based on cost. Since you understand the fundamentals. Right?
Up. I can't hear you, and you're at one position like your screen has frozen. Yeah, no movement.
How's it?
And you're cutting. You're breaking. You're saying sentences are not like you're breaking up.
So, now, back up for instance, again.
So, back up for instance, again.
I want you to look at it, they are waiting here. If you are saying during the year, Nick sold 10 million goods to Gary at a markup of
5 million.
So, what it means is that. What it means, let me just go to my. Are you able to see my. Let me go to.
Okay,
are you able to see this machine? Excel, are you able to see it?
This network
is very bad. Okay. Yeah. Hello?
Yeah. Hello.
Okay. So this 10 million is sales, isn't it?
Yes.
It is 10 million sales. So if it is sales, what it means? Do this. Show sales at 125. Somewhere, just write somewhere 125. Cost at 100, meaning the profit margin will be 25. So, for example, I'm trying to type things here. Mm-hmm. So, say 125. Cost 100, then margin 10 million.
Yes.
It is at 10 million. And the cost, we don't know. The cost, we don't know. So, but what we know is that it's 25, because it's 25 markup. Then now, what we actually say, it will be 25 over. And the net profit will be equal. This 25 divided by 125 times 10. Are we there?
Yes.
So to be 25 over 125 times 10 million. Sorry. Yeah, it's going on. Times 10.
So it will be 25 over 100.
Yes, it will be 25 over 125 because sales. Yeah, because sales is at 125, and the value that we have been given, that 10 million, is not cost, it's in sales.
Okay.
So it's like you are saying 125 equals to 10. The 25 will be what? Are we there?
Okay. Yes.
So
the way we calculated, in other words, we're calculating the margin, isn't it? Because we put
yes. just